just looked at Ronald Bondy, and all I could think of was Willie Nelson. I'm sorry. I love Willie Nelson. And when he turned around with that with the hair, and he just looked just like Willie Nelson. I'm going to start singing to all the girls I loved before here pretty soon. Come on, Willie, sing it for me. To all the girls I loved before. Oh, my. Anyway, looks like Ralph won the toss, and he's going to be breaking in this alternate break format, race to five. BCA eight ball. BCA rules. What can I tell you? I don't want to say this is bar table eight ball. This is 7 foot diamond action. Bar tables are the valleys with the huge pockets and the undesirable rails. These are 7 foot diamonds. Left-hander. 15 years going to Vegas playing with the same team. They finally made one change. I told him they got a ringer. He started laughing. What a nice guy he is. He really seemed nice. I just asked for his name and where he was from, and he gave me his life story real quick. He said, I got 15 seconds of fame. Here it goes. Nice gentleman. Ron, of course, you've seen him on the stream now. I think this is probably his third appearance on the stream this week. No information for him. I'm trying to find out what Ralph's Fargo rating is, and I'll give you an estimated percentage.
616.
He's a pretty strong player. He's got a 16 rating. So knowing what I know about Ronald and him having a 616 rating, I'm going to come out of the box here, and I'm going to predict a win from the San Diegan. I'm not playing preferences. I'm just going by the... I estimate Ronald's game to be somewhere between a strong 6 and a mid 7. And I know that a 600 score is a solid 7, possibly an 8. And maybe I'm wrong. Let's see. Let's see how it holds up. This is a total guess on my part. I'm sorry, but it's a total guess on my part. And I really haven't ever really seen Ronald play until I saw his Scotch double matches. But opened up with a shot. Didn't follow up with a shot, though. Looks like he might be able to play. Well, I don't see what he can play here. Made a stripe, so can't play the one ball. Banking the 11. Somebody move the two ball, please. This might just barely go by. Let's take a look. Yep, I thought so. That's great, Cardiac Kid. Could you imagine being married to Willie Nelson if you're a woman? Oh, my Lord. He's a character. Quite the character. It's funny, I like him a lot as an artist, as a, you know, type of person he is, as a character. I've never seen him in concert. Never. Well, Ron's going to try to make short work of this. He pockets his 15 ball in the corner pocket. With slow speed, he's going to give himself a shot on the 12 to the opposite corner. After that, he gets on the 11 or can get up on the combination in 13-10. Or you can pick it apart and take one ball at a time. It's up to him. But I'm shooting the 15 softly and getting on the 12. And if I was doing that, I'd be shooting the wrong balls. Oh, my. I'm going to stop drinking tequila, guys. I think I'm stopping that for the rest of the night. I was kidding. I'm not really drinking tequila. Well, actually, I am. But it's just for my throat. It's called medicinal purposes. Going for the combo first right off the bat. Well, I would not. I would go for that 15. You've got a problem ball. The problem ball is a 12. You can make that combination all day. Into tomorrow. And you can get there from the 11. Or the 12. Or the ball you're shooting now. Interesting. Interesting. I might have to backtrack on my prediction, but I can't. I already called it. I already called my prediction. I'm going to have to stick to it, even though I think this is an even match. I think Mr. Tomeoni used to play very, very well. I think now. It's a long trip from San Diego. Nice shot. Very, very nice shot. Great shot, in fact, and no reward. None whatsoever. He was very close to scratching. Very close to scratching, but didn't. What do you do with this shot, folks? What do you do here? Can you see the two balls? My question. It looks real close to the 9, to the 8. Steve, can you get me a shot from the right, from the right side? That's not. How about the other side? Maybe I can see. It looks like he can't. He must not be able to see this two ball because he'd be shooting this two ball. And if he's attempting to bank that shot, my lord. But I tell you what, he did do is he left a pretty low percentage. He doesn't have a shot. He doesn't have a shot. Just don't leave him. Ronald, don't leave him over by the 12 on the right side. Or the 10, excuse me. I'll tell you what he can do here. He can hit this 12 into the 3 and just leave the cue ball on the bottom rail. Now, I'm going to play my skill, my opponent's skill level here. I'm going to open up the 3 ball and bring the cue ball to the bottom rail. I'm just going to open it up and say, challenge him to run out. Now, against a, 8-rated player, 9-rated player, 10-rated player in Arizona, probably won't do that. But I would do that in this instance. It's a race to 5. And he just stops the cue ball right on top of that ball. He's liking life. Just like that. There you go. Perfect. But, yes, he has an easy return safety. Little banter between the players. Ralph says to Ronald, hey, you started. You played the first safety. This will be the last match for the night. And again, since he can't see the two ball, since he's got the 11 ball, locked up. I'm going to go ahead and try to bank this three ball to the lower right-hand corner pocket. I'm going to go ahead and open this up. It's hard for Ronald to get shape on that 11 ball. He's got a landing pattern of about maybe 3 inches on the left side. No lead to get there. He's going to have to use speed to get there. Not sure. It's a high percentage shot for him, so I'm just going to open up this ball and try to make it one rail on the bottom. I got to open it up. I can't leave it there. I cannot leave it there, and I cannot give a ball in hand. I'd be banking that three ball back all day. Interesting. Now with ball in hand, he's doing the right thing. He's addressing the problem ball. But he's also inviting his opponent, opening it up for his opponent. I think I deal with the ball by the three before I dealt with that ball. He was trying to roll that ball. He kind of got upset at himself for not rolling the ball, the cue ball. That might have been because he put it too close. How do you do this three ball? He can't open it up now. That's for darn sure. I'm not making this two. I'm hanging it up. I'm not making the two. I'm going to hang it up. Now, see, he was just firing at that ball. If he hangs the ball up and he plays him down here, gives him a shot at it, he now has a shot to get on or open up the three from anywhere on the table. That's fantastic. I want to shoot the 13 ball, put it in front of a pocket, and let him deal with the 3. If I couldn't make the 4. The 12, I mean. Same color. Sorry. I'm not moving that ball because that opens up. Well, that doesn't go by the 12. Never mind. I would open that ball up. That way I just have one ball to worry about. Good shot. Draw the skew ball. Draw the cue ball. He doesn't listen to me. No one ever does. Can't blame him. Okay, Ralph. He's going to open up the three again. That's his only shot. He's going to have to try to... He could try to make this off the ball. It won't go, but he could try. Oh, my Lord. It was a lot closer than I thought. I didn't think he had room to get by there like that. Wow, what a nice shot. Pocket's open, though, so solid to Ronald. Destiny's in his own hands. First game, race to 5. Take the lead or drop the lead? Got an open table. What to do? Cut this ball in. He should be safe even if he misses it. Oh, no. He'd have been in the same place if he played the ball. If you miss it, the ball that was there blocks the 3 when you come off the rail. So, would have been in the same place. He's now giving him a kick shot, a rather easy, a lower percentage kick shot, higher percentage kick shot. If the ball throws, he could follow it in. But he's got a kick shot, and he'll have a shot on the 8 if he makes it. Kicking it he is. And that's what I was afraid might happen. He hit that pretty hard. I would not have hit that ball that hard. Well, now he's kind of tied it up. So, again, Ron is now free to shoot whatever he wants, except he gives up a bank shot shooting this ball if he misses it. Yellow. Now, I would follow this ball down for shape on that ball. Make sure. The only thing you can do is, the only thing you can do is go down too far. Scratch, too, but go down too far. You want to come down a little further than that. Now you got no angle to get on the other ball. I'm going to go ahead and move the other ball. I'm not touching that ball. I can't get on the ball. I'm not going to touch it. I would have just put this ball in front of the pocket, in front of a pocket, and pushed it towards a pocket. Left them nothing on the three, except the kick shot. But he was able to, execute. Houston, we have a problem. I'm jacked up in Tucson, Arizona. But it doesn't matter. I can still make the ball. Good shot, Ronald. First game. Ronald Bondy takes the first game over Ralph Tomeoni. Tucson over San Diego. We're in Tucson, Arizona, Casino del Sol. I was looking over at Steve. I thought I was going to run a Casino del Sol commercial. Guys, if you're not here, I don't know how many times I've said this over the past last night and today. What they've set up down here is just really, really nice. This rivals anything I've ever seen set up in any casino. Sorry you're missing it. It's all posted in Facebook on Arizona Pool Players. And there's pictures of it posted by Rick Schmitz. Several people have taken a couple of shots. Ozzy posted a video of when they put it together. It was a time-lapse video. It's pretty neat, actually, watching them all put it together in, like, about 3 seconds. 32 tables on one side. The pit here, Pro Arena. Table over by Billy Palmer's Billiard Supplies. Got a vendor. And a pool table next to it. Got Mike Massey playing his guitar right now, right by that table. So, interesting place. Interesting evening. Good place to hang out this weekend. If you like pool, guess what? You have your hands full right here. Come on down and watch matches all weekend long. We'll have the Scotch doubles final tomorrow. More than likely, 10 a.m. or 11 a.m. That's what time we started today, I believe. He's going underneath it, and all he does is block that six. Well, I was taking a look around and saying, what can I do here? He's got stripes, so he's going to play the 12 ball on the side and open this ball up. Never mind, he's not opening it up. Now, what he can do here is play the 10 ball off that 15 that's by the 7. That lays it on the rail all together and come out for it. There you go, there you go. Opens it up. Could have done it two different ways. He did it his way. I could have done it my way. His probably worked better than mine. Mine was too complicated. I'd have drawn the ball and gotten on the 11. And now, can he get up there? Yeah, answer is yes. Low left English. That draw just come up. No. Come off the rail. Didn't have to. He's straight into the corner pocket on the, looks like the 12 ball. It's right by the side pocket. He's straight in. And he'll come back just a little bit for that 11, for that upper ball in the upper right-hand corner pocket. Now he wants to get underneath this. He can come over and get straight in for the corner pocket on the left, the bottom. At speed, though. He's got to have good speed control for that. He came down here. That's what I thought. He's in trouble. He'll have to run the cue ball to get shape on the 8, but he'll just come off the rail for shape on the 9. And he'll be drawing this. Well, can he follow the ball? I'm not sure. He looks like he's drawing the ball. He's just stopping it. Just stopping it and make the 8. Oh, my Lord. Straight in. Misses it and ties it up. They just stopped the ball and make the 8. That's exactly what he decided to do. And it looked that easy that he took it for granted. And guess what? Your 7-foot diamond table, 4 3/8 pockets. Guess what? Spit it out. Said, no, you're not coming in today. Hit me center or don't hit me at all. Ron could have out number 2 here. He can go into these balls. Open him up right now if he wants to. Apparently, he doesn't have to open him up because one of the balls goes. I may decide not to even touch those balls. Leave the one ball where it's at and come down here and shoot the 6. Put the 6 in front of the pocket. Challenge my opponent to beat me from there. Go ahead. You don't get safe, you lose the game. How's your Thursday night going out there, guys? We're in Tucson, Arizona, loving life. Casino del Sol. Get away from there. That's a good place. Oh, yes, just blocked it, so he can't even move the 9. Let's leave it there, and I'll take ball in hand, and I'll deal with those 2 balls up there now. If that 7 ball goes in the left-hand corner pocket, he'll just take ball in hand, play that there, follow it, play the 4 ball in the opposite corner, and get out. Better hit this ball or this ball in hand. He's not liking it. Did not hit it. So close, but yet so far away. It's still ball in hand. Now we'll see if that 7 ball goes. It sure does. Connect the dots here, folks. Connect the dots. Follow this for the 4. Come down for the ball in the side pocket or play the one in the corner and get for the ball in the side. And you're straight in on the 8. Maneuver yourself so you end up with the cue ball close to the spot. Don't tie up that one. After you shoot the 1 ball, the cue ball has to be close to the spot. Or against the rail on the right side. Perfect. Slow down. Keep going. Slow down. Keep going. Slow down. Well, this cue ball will end up where he wants it to. Just execute the shot. It's 2 rails shaped. Just slide by the side pocket on the left. You're becoming 2 rails into the bottom corner pocket. Don't hit it that hard. There you go. Nobody turned in the phone to you guys? No. Don't draw this. You want high English on this ball? Oh, my. He could have run it a lot easier. He's calling this ball. He could scratch off the side in the in the corner off the eight. Yes, that's exactly where your cue ball is going. Guess what? You're going to hit that eight ball probably and say hello to that corner pocket. He's not your needle friend. Overcut it. It's left a low percentage shot, but it's not. It's a makeable cut. And the cue ball. But there's no safety here. Looked like he miscued. Oh, my, my. Well, I suggest his bank shots get really accurate. ""15 years playing on the same team. Can he make this? He's going to play safe. Pretty well done. But if you have a kick shot, this is as easy a kick shot as you're ever going to get. I guess if it's in the jaws of a corner pocket, it'd be easier, so maybe not. Guardia kid, have a good time. See you tomorrow. One of the gentlemen or people in the chat room signing off for the night. Well, there's no tomorrow. Kick this in. Take a two-game lead, or it's the or. It's the or. He says, forget it. Here you go. That's the first time I've seen a game given away. Well, we have Ralph breaking the balls at 1-1. Cue ball just slides over to the side pocket and says, I'm going in the drink. Ronald takes ball in hand and says, I want a 2-1 lead. Let me at these balls. Well, Ronald says, whoa. Putting brakes on that eight ball. Here we go. He's trying to figure out what he can do. He's only got three ball, four balls to shoot at, I guess. He's got this combo that he really can't afford to take, as that ball just might knock that A ball in the side pocket. He can't really afford to leave his opponent, let his opponent come to the table in an advantageous position. So, got to make it uncomfortable for my opponent. What do? Block the deuce. Put the 10 ball in front of the deuce. That's what he did. Left one ball up on top. It looks like you can see the 6 ball on the bottom part of the table. And he's got no apparent shot at the 5 ball unless it goes between the 10 and the 8 into the side. If it does that, he can't take it yet. He's got to get a better angle for it. So he's going to open up with 1 ball. Yeah, works. He just gave himself a shot by opening up, pushing that 7 ball out of the way. He gave himself a shot on the 4, I think. 4 on the side, and he'll end up with a 7 in the side off the 10 if it goes. He can either play position for the 7 or play position for the 6 on the bottom here by the corner pocket. Just follow it softly. There you go. There you go. Now, does that ball go in by the 10? If it does, if you can clip the 10 ball going in, you can open up that deuce. You got the 10 and the deuce locked up by the side pocket, and he's got to move that deuce if he wants to get out. He also has to move the 8 ball because it won't go by that 14, but it will bank to the side if he moves the 14. If he moves the 14 or the 15, whichever that is. I still get them confused. 6 and the 14 are the same color. The 7 and the 15 are the same color. One has a bluish green. The other is a lime green. So I guess the 7 ball does not go in the side pocket, or he would be moving that ball. Oh, the 3 ball does, he says, so I'm moving that ball. Or is he calling the deuce? He should be able to make this off the 10. I think it goes by the 8 to get to the 10. So, nope, it doesn't. Well, he didn't hit it, but it does not go. Ronald Bondy, surprise me, buddy. Come on. Show me your stuff here. He's going to draw this ball to break the 9 ball off the rail there. Hit it away from the 2. Nicely done. Nice shot on the 10 ball. He's got it open. He's opened it up for a run. This could work very, very well. I don't think he can make the 14. Looks like it's pretty tight by the 8 ball, so he's going to have to end up about where the 15 is to get to the 14. We're over by the 9. Pockets this ball, pockets the 9, get on the 14, get on the 15, and get on the 8. Don't come over so far. Don't miss the ball. Ouch. All he's left is a bank shot on the deuce. Or some type of a safety. Can you see this ball? I don't think he can see it to make it. He can see it to hit it straight on. I don't think he has an angle to cut it to the right side. Interesting. 7 foot. 8 ball on a 7 foot diamond. Interesting. Banking the two. Banking the two. Opening up his balls, but drawback to opening up balls is it also opens them up for your opponent. I would be getting on the 14 here. Off the 9. Actually, no. I take that back. He's going to come over too far. He's forced himself to shoot the 9 ball or cut the he can't cut the ball inside. I don't shoot that ball now, but the thing about it, yeah, I guess you're going to have to. Going to have to go back and forth. You can end up on either side of the table. As long as he's on one side or the other, you have a shot either on the 9 or the 15. Got to make the ball. And he would have had his choice of shots. Now, Mr. Tomeoni comes to the table shooting solids. 7 ball in the corner. Probably going to run in. No, he's going to draw the ball away from that. So he's probably going to run into the 9. Gonna come up. Shoot the 2 ball. Interesting. He better take a look at this. He better take a look at this, because he's going to want to make sure he can end up down here by this 14 ball on the lower right-hand side of the table to shoot the 8 ball up table. I don't think he wants to take bank. So 5 ball goes. So is he going to follow this or draw this? There you go. He's going to draw it over for the 5. No, he's not going to. He's going to have to play the 5 now. Play the 5, get on the 3, and then slide over for the 8. This is just center English. Just draw it, don't scratch, come back to where you are right now. If you can get back to where he's at right now, you can get on the save ball real nice. You can get on it real nice. This should be the last match of the night. This will be the last match of the night, so it's a race to 5. We're at 1-1. We're at the end, towards the end of the first game. Ronald's got a fan club over there. He's got Stephen Barker, who's playing Scott's doubles with, against Scott Vogelsberg. He's got some people around him supporting him. And Ralph is here from San Diego, all on his own. But he's got to get down here. That ball's still there. Okay, good, good, good. No, you're good. Still blocking knees. He's got to get on a save ball. Ouch. Well, the 8 ball is now going to be going off the 5 in the side. After he shoots the 14 ball. 14 ball should be the last shot he shoots. 9 ball, 10 ball, bounce off the rail, get as straight as you can on the 14 ball. Make it, just leave the cue ball there and shoot the 8 off the 5. Count it up, 2-1. Ronald Bondy. Left himself just perfect. Just perfect. Whatever you do, don't get behind those balls. And don't come beneath the 14. This works. Just key in on making the ball. Don't scratch on the side. He's got to hit this 5 ball pretty full. It could, he could hit the 5 ball and not make it. Unlikely, but as I see it from this angle, from the monitor, he could. He wants to hit the 5 ball pretty full. Just Don't scratch on the side. Oh, it's not that full. That's why I like to be straight in on that ball. He should have, if he could have kept the cue ball against rail, but even that shot, he had a good opportunity. He was just too concerned about that side pocket, and he spun the cue ball the other way to avoid it. And instead of taking a 2-1 lead, he's going to go down 2-1. Two-game swing. Instead of leading 2-1, you're down 2-1. Not a good thing. We're in Tucson, Arizona, Casino del Sol. Tucson warm-ups for the 39th Annual National Championships in conjunction with the 8-ball U.S. Open, the 10-ball U.S. Open. Sponsors, azbilliards.com, Magic Q, Magic Rack, Kamui, Predator Qs, CSI, Viking Qs, the official cue of the national championships. Diamond Products, Cyclops Balls, Yvonne Simonis Cloth, Dry Break, Ouch. Mr. Tomeoni back to the table, sitting there thinking, well, what do I do? I need to get another game. 2-1 just doesn't make it. It's a 5-game race. Down the corner. Table still open. If you take solids, you got problem balls with the 4, the 3, the 1. Even the 5 is a problem ball. You only have 3 open balls. If you take stripes, you got the 9 ball. And you've got a nice combo on the bottom. So actually, those aren't really a problem, but you got to get something to hit them with. And you can get them with that ball by the corner pocket. Shoot that into the 1, make the 10. Right there, just like this. I might have to leave that ball there, that 13. And I'm going to go ahead and shoot this ball that you're looking at, and he's looking at, into the 1 ball, making the 10. And finding a way to get to that ball by the 4 in the middle of the table. If I can break that one open, I'm home free, and I don't want to scratch off that ball. Ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Suggestion to players, when you're going to run a ball off of another ball, try to calculate the path of the cue ball. Don't run into other balls that might lead you to a pocket. Of course, hindsight is 20/20, so that, you know, warned us about that. Decisions, decisions. Where do we go from here, folks? He's got solids. The 5 ball is the only problem ball. I believe it banks to the lower left-hand corner pocket. 4 ball is a problem ball, but it goes to the side on the left side. And he's got ways to get to it. So, get to it and start running some balls. Stop. Oh, he didn't stop that ball very well. He kind of, his mechanics are a little, he's moving during the shot. Saw that a couple times now. He meant to stop that ball dead, and he moved into it and wasn't able to stop it because of the way he stroked it. Okay, now where do we go? Cut the one, the three ball to the side. Cut the four ball to the side. You got to remove the five ball. I'm playing this four ball on the side and moving the five. I'm going to try to hit it into the 13 and make the 13. In doing so, that'll leave me a shot on the three, leads me to the two, back to the five, and I've got an out on the eight. If I can execute it the way I lined it out, just like that. Well done. Well done. Came out okay. Shape on the three or shape on the deuce. The problem with shape on the deuce is it's harder to get down for the eight. He's got a nice angle to come to this ball. If he just steps off, if he just comes off the rail a little bit, and get, if he gets straight into the deuce, he can just draw it back for the eight. And that's where I'd be looking to go. Don't need to swing down, just draw it straight back. You're drawing it maybe 10 inches into the rail. Speed won't matter. If you draw it 10 inches or 14 or 15 or 18, you're still good. This works too, only this can be drawn a lot further. Make sure you get the ball back to at least where it's at now. Get it back to where at least the cue ball is now. Unless you want to be faced with a very difficult shot on the eight. Oh, and by the way, pocket the deuce. And Ralph says, I'll just make it look easy and I'll do it perfect. What do you think? Takes a 3-1 lead. In a race to five over Ralph, over Ronald Bondy. We're at Casino del Sol in Tucson, Arizona. You guys tired of hearing me say that yet? Not the casino. The casino's awesome. If you've ever been out here, they have a great, great casino. The ceilings are painted like the sky, a la what's that one in Vegas that has the ceilings painted? I think it's the French one. I forget what it is. But makes it feel kind of open, daytimey. It's a nice feeling when you're inside. You like hanging out in casinos. It makes it nice to be in there. The buffet is excellent. I've had it on numerous occasions. Very, very good. They've got a golf course that ranks in the top 20 golf courses of Arizona. What else can I tell them? They've got this ballroom that they help set up with lights for 34 tables. Actually, 33 tables we're playing on, one by Billy Palmer's Billiard Supplies and Mike Massey over doing giving lessons and exhibitions and training with his training aid, stroke training aid. Ronald Bondy is making short work of this rack. Can get on this ball on the bottom. He's just tied that ball up even more. He's tied it up even more. Tough to predict what he's going to do here. His only play is the 11 ball. Now, I may have shot that in the opposite corner pocket. And what he shot it at. Would have had the same result of shape on the 13. But he did not shoot it in that pocket. He shot it in the other pocket and left it in front of the pocket he shot it at. That's a good thing. Race to five, BCA ball rules. Ralph Tomeoni at the table. Tomeoni at the table, leading 3-1. Calculating his moves here. Five ball in the side pocket, combination. Not a combination, I was totally mistaken. Again. I'm shooting the two ball here. Shooting the two ball in the side pocket for shape on the four. Shape on the four. Okay, never mind. Shoot this ball. Clutter. Clutter, clutter. Only available shot, I believe, is the three ball. Four ball, two ball does go in the lower corner pocket. But he'll shoot the three ball to the corner with shape on the one, which is the upper right-hand corner of the table. And the less he bounces, the better off he is. He's okay. This will lead him right into the two ball. If he can get straight in on it, he can win the game right here. Because he'll get straight in on the two, stop it for the four. Stop it for the four. He could shoot the six or the seven ball that's next to the eight and then get back on the four. But that's, I'd rather just shoot the four now. And bring it back a little bit for shape on the other corner pocket and get out. Or follow it for shape on the side. Or corner. I personally don't like playing balls to the side pockets because pretty much all I play anymore is one pocket. And I'm never shooting to the side pockets. So I'm uncomfortable when I have to shoot to the side pockets unless they're straight in. He just took a trip around the world on his 7-foot diamond and came up. I'm pretty sure he can't make the four. He's going to have to move the two ball down. He could bank the four. No, he doesn't. He can't bank the four either. Interesting. I would hit that with right English and come to the other side of the table, leaving it over by on the 13 side by the deuce to get on the deuce and get out. Or get on the 7. But he went all the way around the table at warp speed. I thought they were going to need a referee. I was about to call for one. I cannot tell them whether it's a good hit or bad hit. Not my job. But that was a good shot, I can tell you that. And I can tell you that if I'm Ronald, I want to place this cue ball up where the 13 is. You know what else you can do here? It looks well. Looking at the monitor, it looks like there's room. It's just nuzzle past that ball by the side pocket right there. The Kilscher's ball to the cue ball. Nuzzle past it and leave him right behind it. If he doesn't do it, he sells out the four and possibly the game. But I think this goes because the second ball stops the first ball and the cue ball gets behind it. Well, he just lined him up on all three balls and says, you know something, deal with this. He could go rail first. And it also looks like this combo might work too. 7-2. Well, he's trying to get between him and the hook. Oh, he didn't get it done. Now you definitely want to play a safety here. make this pawn side and follow it. But I'm sorry, if he does that, he opens up that ball next to it. He's in a tough place. Can't tell if he has a shot on this ball or not on the 11 ball. And even hitting to the right side of the 13, he's risking a scratch. Well, let's see what happens. He's got a shot on the 4. He's got a shot on the deuce. But he's got to be able to get to that three-ball cluster and open that up. Get a shot on that six-ball. Well done. Except for one thing, he tied his own balls up. Kind of kinky tying his own balls up, but he's left a straight-in shot on the 12. Make this, you got shots. Miss it, you left shots. But you basically just left one shot. I'd open this up again. I'd open them up. I'd call the 4 ball and hit the combo. He can bring the cue ball to the bottom of the bottom rail and pretty much leave him safe again. Not hard. Well, I didn't see that. Nice shot. Well done. Gives you a good idea of the different variations of 8-ball that's available. Different minds see different things. And will this go in? Oh, my. He used all 4.5 inches of that pocket and then just kind of laid it in off the side. 4-1 lead. Don't scratch on the side. There it is, right down the drink. Ronald's got a great opportunity. He's running out of them. He's got to open up these balls, these 2 balls. Now, question. Do you play safe behind that ball? Or do you just go ahead and run out? You just play the run out. Play the ball in the corner. And he's going to play the ball on the side. Either way, make the ball get shape on that ball and then get up and get the rest of them and get out. Just negotiate your way around the table. Get out. Death by stroke. Yes, they have been mucho misses. Couple of good shots. They both had chances to be at 3-1. But Ralph is there. He's going to roll right up to the 13 ball. Not try to make anything here. Well, never mind. That ball goes, so why not just run out? Pocket the 13. Get out. Where'd the cue ball end up? What kind of shots he got, I can't tell. He said, there he is. There it is on the monitor. Well, I've seen tougher positions to get out of, but I think he could have done worse as ended up on the right side of the table. Nicely done. Don't hit the 8. Ooh. Ouch. It's a cut. I'm going to put an abundance of left English on this ball and cut it down the rail. Let the cue ball go bang, 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 bang and test the rails. Overcut it. Cue ball, cue ball, cue ball. He's down 4-1. Ronald's had some opportunities, and he hasn't capitalized. Thus, he finds himself in a position of desperation. Trails 4-1. I believe he's breaking the balls. I think Mr. Ralph Tomeoni broke first. I guess I was mistaken. Again. We've got matches going on. I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We still got 6 matches going on the side there, 7. Ronald's breaking the balls, trailing 1-4. Open break, dry break. Trailing 1-4. Can't afford to shoot that. Can't afford to leave that. Table is completely open. Ralph can pick this apart and close the match out right here. I think I'm going to draw this ball with a little bit of center low and come into the 13 for the 5 in the side and just run out. You better get straight on that 5 ball. He didn't, but he's got shape on the 1. There's just different things. After seeing how he shot that, that's probably a better way to shoot it than what I would have done, because I was risking getting tied up going across balls. He didn't risk a thing except missing a ball. Except missing a ball. Well, Ronald's faced with the same thing. An open table. Nothing blocking it. Nothing preventing him from taking the win and going in the second game. And race to 5. Keep in mind that all these matches that you're watching on the live stream will be posted to YouTube on the CSI site. YouTube, YouTube user CSI pool, I believe. They'll flash it on the screen. And you can go there, and there's instructional videos. There's the podcast. There's several things available. Looks like Ralph's gonna take a little break, so we'll run a couple of ads. Can I get the YouTube banner up? Can I get that up? Let's see if we can take a look at it for you here. Tell you just what's available. There you go. You see pro matches. You'll see matches like this across the country, from the warm-ups, from the regionals, instructional videos, CSI podcast, player interviews, and there's the website, youtube.com/users/CSI pool. There you go. Go there and knock yourself out. There's a lot to see there. You can watch your own matches and maybe learn something from watching yourself play. Thanks, Stephen. And you're looking at $800,000 for the 39th annual, available for the 39th annual national championships. at the Rio in Las Vegas, Nevada. Put on by CSI Sports, CueSports International. Southwest Regional, September 3rd through the 7th, Fort McDowell, Scottsdale, Arizona, coming up. I think we're going to be spoiled here. We're going to expect the same setup over there. Wow, what a treat, what a treat. U.S. Open 8-Ball, U.S. Open 10-Ball Championships, July 24th through the 31st, Rio, Las Vegas, Nevada, for Moscone Points. Predator, the official cue. Kamui, the official tip. USAPL National Championships. Pool League. That's where you guys all get to play. Most of us get to play in July. Viking Cues is the official cue. Omega Billiards is the official store. Put on by CSI. At the Rio in Las Vegas, Nevada, we got one player back, one player missing in action. The player that's going to shoot is missing in action. He said, I need a bathroom break. I'll be right back. And actually, good call. Okay, we're back in action. Ralph's going to shoot the solids. Try to close out this match here. Everything's available. Two rails for shape on a one or shape on a five. Actually, shape on a five. play the five in the upper corner. Oh, he went too far? Yes, he did. Same position. Actually, he's going to draw straight back for it. To be right about where he's at now. Maybe even come back further for the side pocket. See what he does. Oh, not over a ball. That is the last place he wanted to leave that cue ball. Last place in life. He's over a ball. And now you see where he's going with his cue ball. Away from the eight. Instead of towards the eight. Not a good thing. He didn't hesitate. He just fired that ball. Over a ball, and he just fired it. Straight in on the eight ball. Close out the match if you make this ball. Well, just don't go in that corner because you will lose the game. I don't know what the comment was, but the response was sure. And they got a good laugh out of it. So, well, last opportunity for Mr. Bondy. Get up on that 12. There you go. I believe he's going to come up for the balls in the upper. Oh, no, he's not. Two ways you can play this. You can just stop it there for the 14 and come off the rail for the other ball, or he can just follow this ball down to the rail and up. You don't want too much distance here. You also don't really want to be straight in on this ball because he can just bounce it off the rail. Whoa, that was close. I would prefer to have it on that line right there than the line he's on. Because as he comes off this rail, that cue ball is going to have a tendency of going towards that side pocket. And you got to be concerned with speed. Your adrenaline's flowing. It is so easy to overamp this ball. I don't think the ball on the left goes. It has to play the ball on the right. He's missed it. He's left the cue ball where he exposed enough of the A ball to lose the game. Left enough exposed that this match is more than likely over. And it is 5-1, Ralph Tomeoni. Excuse me for a second. I'm going to hand the score sheet to